Hello and welcome to the Whisky.com news on the 16th of June 2020. And we have a number of very, very interesting news. The first news is from the Fèis Ale Festival that was postponed this year. And Caol Ila and Lagavulin are now presenting their Fèis Ale limited editions festival bottlings. The first one, Lagavulin, is a 20-year-old and is limited to 6,000 bottles, 54% ABV. It was finished in PX and Oloroso casks. Then the Caol Ila is a 16-year-old. It was also finished in Amoroso casks. It's limited to 3,000 bottles with 53.9% ABV. Then we have, from the independent bottler, the news about the new Epicurean. It's the Epicurean Cask Strength Edinburgh. Yeah, it's a cask strength whiskies from the lowlands. It's a blend and it's limited to 600 bottles. It's 53.3% ABV, so it's a relatively light cask strength whiskey without coloring, without chill filtration. Then we have the pro golfer Rich Beem is now featured at Loch Lomond. He becomes a brand ambassador, and the Loch Lomond is very, very involved within the golf in sport. They're hosting the tournament The Open, and he will be an ambassador there for the whiskey. Then we go over the small pond to Ireland, and we've already mentioned it in one of our videos. The master distiller Brian Nation is quitting, and now Kevin Gorman takes over his job. So he will become the new master distiller. He works for Midleton since 1998, so that has been a really long time now. And they probably talked about this continuation for a long time. So he has been well trained over the last 20 years, and he will probably do a very, very good job. Then we have news from Teeling. Teeling in Dublin is planning to reopen their visitor center. Yeah, they closed due to the pandemic, but now they're reopening for a 7-day week, and they will do tours and they will do tastings, probably with smaller groups and with distancing guidelines and hygiene and everything. Yeah. Then we have another news from Redbreast in Ireland, and that is the Redbreast Dream Cask. Thousands of people participated in the fair, where you get a little vote where you can buy, and you get a chance to win one of the buys. So not everybody gets this highly limited bottle, so everybody gets one little share, so you get a chance of winning this. Then we have news from the international company of Diageo, and they are now announcing that they are switching from the regular glass bottle at Seagram's to a recyclable plastic bottle. Yes, they are now bringing out Seagram's Seven Crowns in a plastic bottle. It has a lot less energy intake, because melting the glass is really, really expensive, and you cannot have a glass that you can reuse, because it's a very strange glass and sorting this glass would not be feasible. So they are trying to reduce the amount of energy put into the bottle, and hopefully this will have a good impact. But that was it for this week. Thank you very much for watching, and see you next week.